It doesn't matter what kind of application you're building, usually you need a way to let users know what's going on, whether that's in-app notifications or external notifications through SMS, through Slack, or email. Laravel makes it incredibly easy to send emails and notifications can send emails too, so it can get a little bit confusing. Let's take a look at when you would reach for one over the other. Laravel notifications can send emails to your users, but notifications are going to be a little bit more in-depth, a little bit more flexible, a little bit more customizable than your traditional Laravel mailable system. So if you're just sending emails to your users, would you reach for notifications over Mailable? Well, maybe. It all depends on your personal preferences, as well as maybe your company's or team's structure on how you want to reach for notifications or Mailables. But let's go ahead and build something so that we can see when notifications might be a great option, because we can have that expandability option in the future, and when mailing is just fine. Let's say we have an application where people can register for local meetups. Now, the people who are registering, who are choosing a particular meetup, entering their name, entering their email, they're not necessarily users within your application, within this meetup application. But you might have organizers for each individual meetup to be able to create their own meetups for people to register too. And maybe they want to have a way of receiving people's information who have registered for this meetup. So you kind of have two different types of users, people who might not necessarily be logged in, authenticated users to your application. In this case, I'm just typing in my name and then my email, but you will have organizers who are users. So maybe we can send a notification to a user, the organizer, when someone signs up or registers for a meetup, and maybe we can send a mailable, an email, to a user, in this case, a registrant, who is just entering their name and their email. And this is not some clear-cut way of saying this is when you use notifications and this is when you use mailables, but hopefully it gives you a little bit of a clearer picture on when some of that customization or expandability in the future might be useful when you're choosing notifications over mailables. Now, for the front end implementation of what we're going to be looking at, I'm going to be using Livewire, Livewire Volt specifically, but this can be applicable whether you're using Inertia or Blade. You would just put that in your controller rather than the component class that I'm using here. So when a guest registers, they're not authenticated. We're just asking them for their name and their email. And what's happening right now is we're validating that information and then finding the particular meetup that they are registering to so that we have this information to do with when we send it to a notification and to a mailable. And then we're just showing a toast saying, hey, thanks for signing up. Why don't we get started? Let's go ahead and create the notification first so we can notify our organizer. PHP artisan make notification. Now, what should the notification be named? Maybe we say new signup because there is a new signup for that particular organizer's meetup. And we're not going to create a markdown view. Perfect. New signup created successfully. Let's go ahead and go to that. Now, notifications can be extremely customizable, extremely flexible, and extremely powerful. And we're really only touching on one aspect, sending emails through notifications. So be sure to check out the docs for other ways to use notifications, from sending SMS to being able to send Slack notifications, and even a ton more through third-party implementations as well. Notifications can be queued or sent immediately, and then notifications can have multiple things that happen within a notification. For example, maybe we're sending an email as well as an SMS, and maybe we want the email to send 5 minutes before the SMS does. All that can happen within notifications, within a single notification instance, which is where you can kind of see this can be a little bit more helpful, maybe a little bit more useful in your particular use case over just traditional mailables. And we have this to mail out of the box that says, I want this line, this action, and then another line. So why don't we customize this specifically for the organizer? In the register, we have this meetup. So why don't we go ahead and pass to the notification the email and the name of the person who is registering. Let's go ahead and say public string name and public string email. We don't necessarily need the meetup ID because we're going to be using just the name and the email to put that into the mail that we're sending. We're notifying our user, our organizer of this meetup. We can just add new parameters to this mail message, but you could, if you wanted to, set your own markdown or view specific for this mail message. So if I want to say maybe the subject, for example, let's go ahead and say new meetup registration. And here's where we can kind of implement the name and email of the registrant. We don't necessarily need an action for this particular email. And that looks quite nice. So we have a mail message that notifies our user, our organizer, saying, hey, you have a new registered user for your meetup, because we're going to be passing the name and email to this notification. We have that accepted here in the construct. Now, why don't we go ahead and notify our organizer? If we were to take a look at our meetup table, you can see here that we have an organizer ID that is just linked to our user. And the only thing that you need within your models is for a user. In this case, it's notifiable by default, but you can have any model be notifiable. So in this case, if I was to create a organizer model instead of users, I could have people sign up and be in that organizer model and be notifiable. And that's all that we need for this particular case, because in our register, we can go ahead and say we have the meetup. And because we have the meetup and there's a user and organizer associated with that, we can say meetup organizer notify. And this is some really helpful syntax here to be able to say, okay, I have the organizer. I just want to notify them with this new signup. And again, we're passing the this name and this email that the user, the registrant, has signed up with. So we're just saying the organizer of the meetup, let's notify them. And you can see here how this would be extremely helpful if you needed additional notifications. Maybe you also wanted to send an SMS. Maybe they signed up, hey, I want SMS notifications for a particular sign up. And that's when notifications can come in handy, to be able to notify them all the ways that that particular user wants to be notified. Let's go ahead and sign up. And we have a new email. I'm using Laravel Herd for this, but you can view emails with using the log system or with a third-party email system as well. So here we have, hello, you have a new registered user for your meetup. And then we have the name and email that was passed in to this particular notification. So we didn't set up any extra mailable or any view or markdown file. We just have that notification sending emails right in that one notification class. And just a note, you wouldn't want to send a notification right in line for the request like I am doing here. It probably would be best being done through a queue or using something like the defer function within Laravel. This is just so that if you are sending multiple notifications or multiple people are signing up, especially when we start to send an email, we want all that queued by default. Just for this particular demo, I'm just showing it right out the gate. And that's the good thing with notifications as well. For new signup, we can just say implements should queue, and all of a sudden it is now a only queued notification. But again, for now, just for this demo purposes, I'm going to say we should always just send this within the request. And this can be done per notification and even on a per request basis, where we can say, hey, we'll bypass this and this should be queued, or maybe we want to send this notification now. You can do that according to your specific purposes and your specific needs. Okay, let's create a new email. PHP artisan make mail. And maybe we'll call this sign up confirmed, so that we can send this to the registrant saying, hey, we got your sign up, be looking for an email from an organizer, sign up confirmed. And maybe we want a markdown view. And so you can kind of already see the differences and maybe where you might use mail over notifications. If you know, hey, I just want to send an email right off the gate, I might not need the extra pieces of maybe potentially sending SMS or having to specify a particular user. Mail is great because then you don't have to worry about who is actually getting the notification. Of course, you can send a notification to someone who is not a registered user. But in my mind, I usually like to see it best as notifications are great for in application or for registered users, people who are authenticated with my application, and mailables might be best for people maybe outside of the application. In this case, a registrant isn't a registered user just yet. Okay, we have a sign up confirmed email. Again, we could have this be queued by default, but we're going to leave it just within the request for now. We have the envelope of subject to say, hey, sign up confirm. That's just taking it from when we created the PHP artisan make mail. And then we have the markdown file. Everything looks good here. We aren't necessarily passing anything into this email markdown file. Maybe we'll pass in the meetup name so we can show users what meetup they signed up for. So we could say public string meetup name. Yeah, that should work well. And then in the sign up confirmed markdown, we can place our text here. I just have some sample text, and actually we'll use the name of the person who's registered. So we'll need to add that to the mailable in a bit, but Laravel does give some mail components within markdown that you can use to make your emails just look a little bit nicer. You can see more of those components on the docs that are linked in the description. So button, panel, table, and customizing them is optional. Now back in our sign up confirmed email, let's go ahead and get the name of the person as well. So we have public string name, so that way we can use that in the sign up confirmed blade template, this markdown file. So your registration for the meetup name has been confirmed. Perfect. Hello. Let's go ahead and send this email. Mail to, we can send it to this email. We're going to send a new sign up confirmed email. We can bring that in up here. App mail sign up confirm. That's what we just created. And then I'm going to pass in the meetup name and this name as well. So now we're going to notify the organizer on every new signup, as well as send an email to the registrant, the person who is not an authenticated user, but just registered for this meetup. And then we have two new emails, a signup confirm. This is the one being sent to me as a person who just signed up for this webinar. So your registration for the meetup Python Pioneers has been confirmed, and then a new meetup registration being sent to the organizer. So the email that was associated to the organizer who was part of, or who was hosting the meetup. You have a new registered user for your meetup. So hopefully this gives a little bit more clarity, or just gives you some ideas of when you would want to use notifications versus when you would want to use Mailable. I first started thinking of, is this an authenticated registered user or a model within my application? Notifications is a great option, especially if you need more in-depth or customizable notifications down the line, like sending SMS or Slack or anything else. And then mail is great just for those one-off things, especially if they're not an authenticated user. But ultimately, it comes down to your personal preference and how you want to send emails or notifications with Laravel.